For years, I've been making my mold boxes out of 3/4-inch plywood. They're strong, relatively affordable, cheap, and easy to make, but they do have some disadvantages. So the mold boxes, they're not super accurate. Eventually, the screws will strip out in here, and the system is not expandable like I need it to be for some of the molds that I make. It sure would be great to have a modular mold box system that would allow you to mix and match for whatever it is that you were molding.
My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I'm going to start off this project like I do many others, and that's with a sketch. Doesn't matter if it's 2D or 3D, some sort of visualization of what it is you're going to make as a plan is a really good idea. Link up here on the right to the full video of this sketch. The key to this project is an M6 bolt socket cap head screw and nut, 10 millimeter on the nut, 10 millimeter on the head, 6 millimeter diameter, super easy to work with. I need to establish a system by which I can expand the mold box. Since the nuts and the bolts are essentially 10 millimeters or 1 centimeter, every other space I end up with an odd measurement system. So in this case, I'm building a mold box that is 5 by 7. This wall that I'm building here is 7 millimeters on the inside. So the next size up from that would be 9 millimeters. The next size up from that would be 11 millimeters, allowing me to space every other box size with the bolts. So my system ends up being based on an odd number system. 5 by 7 in this case is the first mold box that I'm making, and I will expand out from there. Let's add a little logo onto the sides of the mold and on the bottom, and then we're just about ready to print the first mold box. For these prints, I'm using a relatively large nozzle size, 0.6 millimeters. Pretty straightforward build. Takes about 3 hours to print one of these parts by themselves. Almost no supports are needed on the 45 degree angle. Some supports for the holes, of course, but a pretty straightforward print. Some cleanup is required. I have to remove the skirt, of course, and the support material inside the holes. I use a card scraper to scrape the edges clean, flat, and square. It's my preferred tool for cleaning up prints. Every edge gets some sort of a cleanup from where it was attached to the print bed. And then we're going to drill all the holes through with a 6 millimeter drill bit just to clean them up and make it easier for me to put the bolts in by hand. After you put them in a few times, they come in and out all by themselves. I put in 10 millimeter mark or fill lines here on the sides of the molds. I actually print those in, but they were too difficult to clean out the support material, so I just colored them in with some Sharpie. Let's go to the supply box and grab ourselves a few handfuls of these M6 socket cap screws with some washers and some nuts so that we can start assembling the mold box. I added space for the flat washers as kind of an extra precautionary thing, but it turned out to be a really good thing, and that's going to prevent the 3D printed parts from getting marred and hopefully last longer. The nuts fit nice and snugly into the holes where they get trapped that we're going to screw everything together with, and I even punch them in here with a punch. Those guys are not coming out. Assembling the mold box is pretty straightforward. Pop the pieces together and screw in the socket head cap screws. I thought that I was going to need some sort of an alignment additionally for the walls onto the floor, but the holes are very tight with the 6mm and alignment happens right through the screws. I think I'm going to be fine even after extended use. Using some sort of a tool to screw the bolts in is helpful. I'm going here really slow because I don't want to break the 3D printed parts. And that working really good. Pretty happy with that. Either by hand or by machine, both works well. Now I'll show you how to take one of the sides off, so pretty straight. And this is a pretty common thing when you are demolding after you've cast the first part of your two-part silicone mold. You'll often have to potentially take one side off, or if you're lucky, just the bottom, but they basically screw out the screws and put it together. Now here's something you probably didn't consider. I can stack these things. So this is going to be great when I flip the mold box over and remove the bottom. If I'm able to keep the first part of the silicone mold intact, then just add on some more walls and just keep everything in the mold box.
I'm very pleased. I'm really just going to be limited by the size of my 3D printer. Yeah, the bolts are a little overkill, but it doesn't hurt. You definitely don't want something like this to leak. You don't have to put a bolt in every single hole for the bigger ones, so I think I'll be fine. I like the system that it's based on, and once I get a bunch of these pieces printed out, I think it'll be a great way to use the ends of the spools from my filament on the 3D printer to use them up and make these little walls for my modular mold box system. I'm looking forward to using these in a future project. I'm sure you'll see them on YouTube very soon. Make sure you like and subscribe. Make sure you turn on notifications for everything so that you don't miss any of my videos.
Don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.